the game that was touted to be the best game of the World Cup, the game that threatened to become a dead rubber because of the domination of two sides in the World Cup, the game that has eventually become a virtual qualifier for one of the two teams. It is number one versus number two, India versus England at Edgbaston. It just doesn't get any bigger than this. And it will be really difficult to spot who's the home side here, because the Indian fans will make sure Edgbaston look like Eden Gardens. Going into the game, England will be the most desperate one, because they need the 2 points for sure to qualify for the semi-finals, because if they lose here and Pakistan win their next game, no matter what happens in the game against New Zealand, England will be out of the World Cup in the group stages. But India, on the other hand, can afford to lose this game and still qualify for the semi-finals, given the fact that they have a slightly weaker opponent in the next two games. But Virat Kohli will make sure that there is no complacency in the camp, and they will be absolutely ruthless against England. As far as team combinations are concerned, we have big news in the England camp. Their opener Jason Roy is back. He may not be 100% fit, but they are just taking a gamble here. They want their best opener to start for them. And unfortunately, Jofra Archer is missing out for them, and Liam Plunkett will take his place. As far as India are concerned, they are unlikely to change their winning combination. Vijay Shankar's place has been a topic of debate over the week, but I think the team management will give him a longer rope. Moving on, the venue Edgbaston. In the game between Pakistan and New Zealand, the ball spun, and it spun a lot. If that's the case, India will definitely have the edge over England, because they have world-class spinners in Kuldeep Yadav and Yuzvendra Chahal. So the game plan for Virat Kohli's side will be to win the toss, choose to bat first, make sure they put a lot of runs in the board, and ask their spinners to attack that England middle order. As far as England's game plan is concerned, they're kind of confused as in which brand of cricket they want to play. They are caught in between attacking and defending. They are finding it hard to strike that balance between attack and defense. Over the last 4 years, they've been absolutely dominant in home conditions. They've invested a lot in playing this brand of cricket, the attacking brand of cricket. They've invested a lot in bringing in the kind of players that they want. And all the hard work that they have put in for the past 4 years has boiled down to this one final game. There has been a lot of unrest in the England camp because of the tussle going on between the current players and the former players. We'll have to wait and see if England can turn up and manage that kind of a pressure and make sure that they bring in their attacking brand of cricket into display. And one more exciting thing to look forward in this game is the jersey of Indian cricket team. The home and away jersey concept has been introduced in this World Cup, and India will be flaunting their new orange jerseys. So it will be really, really exciting to see how they will look like in orange.